Hi Hunters, and Olga is once again with you. In this video, I'm going to analyze Dunnabot Torsion and demonstrate to you how you can use Anaron's features for expanding your capabilities in malware analysis. We'll take a closer look at the HTTP MITM proxy, backup files, and process graph features, as well as several functions that we mentioned earlier in our videos. Let's get it started. If you analyze the samples, use cryptographic protocols designed to provide communication security, such as SSL and TLS, you can check HTTP MITM proxy function. It allows you to save complete HTTP conversation for the later analysis. I wanted to note that with HTTP MITM proxy option, you can also use the route via Tor, but only the fastest geolocation. Today we have a sample for Dunnabot Trojan. It's an advanced banking Trojan malware that was designed to steal financial information from victims. This is one of the most advanced malware thanks to the modular design and the complex delivery method. The task started and we can see that our malicious document proceeds to download something using the system's SVC host process. Let's take a look at the more detail. As you can see, ROM DLL32XE creates its child processes. We have to wait a little more time for detecting, and here we go! Our sample was detected as Dunnabot Trojan. Let's see what triggered it. Well, the source is a network, so obviously the detection was produced by Suricata IDES rule. Let's check to make sure. The switch to the 3rd step, there are different rules, as you can see, and they continue to show up. Go to the connections tab, and what is here? Here we can see the malware using 443 ports to interaction with the network. Let's click on the packet to take a look inside it and know more details. Because malware is using a cryptographic protocol to network interaction, the contents of the packets can be read without using additional tools. Since we have checked HTTP MITM proxy, we don't have any problems. We'll cover it later. While we were checking the information, our sample continued to create a lot of other processes. Let's take a look at several of them. As you can see, by Anaron's indicator, this malware was injected into the Explorer process, and it's creating numerous child processes, which harms the victim's computer undoubtedly. Well, let's look closer to another malware activity. I haven't even surprised. It steals credential data of the victim. I think we've got enough information for analyzing this sample, and we can stop executing the task. Let's go to the process tree and check what is there. How good you can see, it's very big and not going to be used for reading. For cases like this, we can use representation as a process graph. There are a lot of processes, and it may be alarming, but it's easier than you think. We can increase and decrease parts of the graph either by mouse wheel or by plus and minus icons of the upright corner of the windows. You also can choose any process, click on them, and check the advanced details of the process. Using process graph, we can track all malware activities from the start to the end, looking at the processes and their activities. Working with the task, with network activity, you can download backup file. But if you start your task with HTTP MITM proxy, you dig deeper and have got more information. Now let's leave Anaron's interface and continue our investigation. How I mentioned before, when malware uses SSL or TLS protocols to send or receive the information, analysts can use HTTP MITM proxy feature for getting deeper data. Once this feature is on the SSL or TLS master keys, will be locked and saved, so with programs like Wireshark, analysts can decrypt SSL or TLS connections traffic. That is what we are going to do right now. Let's open the previously downloaded pickup file. There are a lot of packets. To do our analysis easier, let's filter packets by IP address from our task. I need to write the info into the bar, and now it looks more clear. By looking inside packets, you can see that they are encrypted and you cannot recognize them. Let's decrypt the data then. It's time to add the file with master keys. Just open the Edit tab and click on the Preference. Go to the Protocols and find either SSL or TLS. In our case, it will be TLS. In the pre-master secret log file name, click Browse button and open previously saved from the task SSL key log file. As you can see, HTTPS traffic is decrypted now, and we can analyze packets and extract information and data from them. In our case, there is an executable file inside the packet. That's all that I would like to share with you today. Thank you for watching this video to the end. I appreciate it if you write your responses and questions below this video. Go to AnyRun service, explore tasks, and upgrade your malware analysis skills. See you in the next videos. Bye!